Dear listeners, tonight I invite you to step into an enchanted world where courage and forgiveness are intricately woven into the delicate fabric of an unforgettable story. Settle in comfortably, close your eyes, and let the silence envelop your soul, guiding you to a magical realm where the gentle light of spring can dispel even the deepest shadows of winter, paving the way for a new beginning filled with hope and renewal. The King and the Fairy Ring. The Curse from the Past. The onset of winter was making its presence felt with an almost deceptive gentleness in the kingdom of Almaris, a land once renowned for its endless springs, green forests, and rivers that flowed endlessly through an idyllic landscape. The weather seemed to be blessed with an endless cycle of warm light and freshness, where each day brought a new fragrance of flowers and a ray of sunshine brighter than the one before. However, this paradise of nature was now just a memory lost in the mists of time. White, heavy snows had covered the kingdom for so long that few of its inhabitants could still remember the days when the fields were covered in flowers and the forests reverberated with the sounds of birds. In Almaris, winter had become not just a part of life, but the very essence of existence. In a kingdom where people were once accustomed to the ephemeral beauty of spring, now each day unfolded under a leaden sky, and the earth seemed locked under a mantle of ice. King Ethan, once a young man full of vigor and ambition, had now reached an advanced age. He was a man whose face bore the marks of time, and his eyes, once full of life, were now shadowed with melancholy and regret. On the long winter nights, when the entire kingdom slept under a blanket of frozen silence, Ethan would gaze out the window of his castle. From there, he could see the endless dance of snowflakes settling over the kingdom, a sight that filled him with deep sadness. The snowflakes, with their delicate and graceful movements, seemed to be carried by a silent wind, like unseen spirits continuing to dance in memory of a time long past. But for Ethan, this sight was a constant reminder of his mistake. Although his throne was covered in gold and precious stones, although he was surrounded by the luxury of a prosperous kingdom, his soul was burdened by the weight of a decades-old secret, a secret that gave him no peace. In his youth, Ethan had been an ambitious young man, eager to protect his kingdom at any cost. The kingdom of Almaris had always been exposed to the whims of nature, and young Ethan was determined to find a solution that would ensure his people's prosperity and safety. On a dark night, a night when the wind seemed to whisper old, forgotten secrets, Ethan heard of a mysterious artifact, a magical ring hidden deep in the enchanted forest, a forest said to be inhabited by fairies, magical beings possessing ancient powers. Legend had it that this ring had the power to bring eternal spring, a spring that would never end and would protect the kingdom from all the dangers of the weather. Driven by a burning desire to secure his kingdom and prevent the hardships that seemed inevitable, Ethan ventured into the heart of the forest, guided only by the faint lights of the moon and an unwavering determination. The enchanted forest was a place of mysteries, where the trees seemed to whisper to each other and the shadows danced to unknown rhythms. Ethan felt that each step brought him closer to an unknown destination, but also that an unseen tension weighed on his shoulders. In a hidden clearing, protected by a magical barrier that he could feel but not see, Ethan found the ring. It was a simple object at first glance, but one that emanated a power. Ethan felt the moment he held it in his hand. With a ring in his possession, Ethan returned to the kingdom, convinced that he had done what was necessary to protect his people. However, what he did not know was that this ring had a power far greater than he imagined, and that stealing it would bring a curse upon the entire kingdom. As soon as the ring was taken from the fairies, winter descended upon the kingdom and never left. The fairies, beings closely linked to the cycles of nature, lost their power to control the seasons, and their fury manifested in the form of an endless winter. Ethan tried repeatedly to restore order, to find a way to confront the fairies' magic, but all his attempts were in vain. Years passed, and the kingdom sank deeper into the cold of winter, while Ethan retreated into silence and regret. Over the years, Ethan sought a solution, but the fairies' magic was too powerful to be defeated. As the years went by, the burden of his mistake became increasingly unbearable. Now, feeling his end near, Ethan knew he had to reveal the secret to his son, Prince Kai, the only hope to right the wrong of the past. Deep in his soul, Ethan knew that only Prince Kai, with his pure heart and iron will, might have the power to repair what he had destroyed. But for this to happen, Kai would have to face the truth, accept the consequences of his actions, and show a courage he perhaps did not even know he possessed. The snowstorm that continued to haunt the kingdom seemed to be just the beginning of a much larger story, a story of redemption, sacrifice, and perhaps forgiveness. Kai was a young man who, despite bearing the responsibility of an entire kingdom on his shoulders, remained untainted by the ambitions of power and the temptations of the treasures he could have at his disposal. For him, true value did not lie in gold or thrones, but in people, in their joy and safety, in the well-being of those he loved and served with such dedication. The people of the Kingdom of Almaris loved him not only for his courage, but also for the gentleness and compassion he showed, qualities that set him apart from other young nobles. Unlike his father, King Ethan, Kai had never been fascinated by political power. He was not the type to be overwhelmed by the desire to control or dominate. His heart was deeply connected to his people, and his greatest desire was to bring relief to their suffering. However, even for a soul as noble and pure as his, the endless winter that dominated the kingdom was a heavy, almost unbearable burden. The cold days and long nights, where the icy air penetrated even the most hidden corners of the kingdom, were hard to bear not just for the body, but also for the soul. Kai saw his people suffering from hunger and cold, saw how their once bright and hopeful faces gradually darkened under the weight of the winter that seemed to have no end. The children, who no longer knew what spring was, grew up in a world where warmth and greenery were just stories of long ago, passed down in whispers by the elderly, like memories that seemed increasingly distant and unreal. In their eyes, the spark of hope gradually faded, and this broke Kai's heart more than anything else. On a cold night, one of those nights when the wind sang its sad song around the corners of the castle, Kai was in the royal library. He often found solace in the pages of books, where old stories and histories helped him escape the harsh reality of his kingdom. But that night, his search had a different purpose. He wanted to find something, anything, that would help him understand the curse that oppressed his kingdom. Among the shelves filled with dusty tomes, in a less frequented corner, Kai discovered an old journal, covered in a thick layer of dust, as if no one had touched it in decades. He carefully opened it, and the pages, yellowed by time, unfolded before him, revealing words written in a trembling hand that was familiar to him. It was his father's handwriting. As he read those lines, Kai felt his world shake. The journal revealed the shocking truth about the enchanted ring and the fairy's curse. He learned how, many years ago, his father, driven by the desire to protect his kingdom, had stolen a ring from the fairies, the magical beings who lived deep in the enchanted forest. His act, though motivated by good intentions, had unleashed the fairies' wrath and brought eternal winter upon the kingdom. Reading those lines, Kai felt a powerful mix of conflicting emotions. Anger enveloped him like a fire, the revelation of his father's actions provoking an inner revolt. How could the king, the man he had respected and loved all his life, have committed such an act? How could he, a ruler who should have protected life, have brought so much suffering upon his people? But as he read on, the anger began to intertwine with another feeling, compassion. Kai understood that his father had not acted out of malice or selfishness, but out of a desire to protect his kingdom, to prevent the disasters he believed were imminent. Ethan had been driven by fear, by the overwhelming responsibility he felt toward his people. However, in his attempt to do good, he had unwittingly caused immense harm. With a heavy but determined heart, Kai knew he had to confront this painful reality. He rose from the table where he had spread out the journal and, with slow but sure steps, went to his father's chamber. The snowflakes continued to dance at the window, and the silence of the night was interrupted only by the crackling of the fire in the hearth. Entering the room, Kai found King Ethan, weakened and near the end, lying in his bed. The king's face was marked by years of suffering, and his eyes, though tired, still seemed to hold a glimmer of courage. Kai approached and, unable to control his trembling voice, confronted him with what he had discovered. He asked him to tell the truth, to confess everything that had happened on that fateful night, to explain why and how he had brought this curse upon the kingdom. The king, overwhelmed by the burden of his own conscience, finally revealed everything to his son. He told him how he had sought forgiveness for years, how he had tried in vain to repair what he had destroyed. He spoke of how every attempt to restore balance had failed, and how, as the winter deepened in the kingdom, his hope gradually faded. Kai listened, with tears in his eyes and his heart broken by the pain he felt in his father's voice. At that moment, he knew he could not remain indifferent. His resolve was clear. He had to right his father's wrong, no matter the dangers that awaited him. He knew the road ahead would be full of trials, but he was ready to face them. Kai, the son of a king who had erred but sought redemption, had now become the only hope for saving his kingdom. At dawn, when the weak rays of the sun barely managed to pierce the gray sky of the endless winter, Kai prepared for the most important journey of his life. The air was sharp and cold, and the entire world seemed frozen under the burden of the snow that had covered the kingdom for so many years. Kai knew that the road ahead would not be easy, but his determination was unwavering. With the enchanted ring at his chest and his sword securely fastened at his side, he took only a few necessary provisions for the journey and set off for the enchanted forest. The forest, once a place full of life and color, had now been transformed into an endless expanse of ice and snow, a place of shadows and mysteries. As soon as Kai stepped into it, he felt the darkness of the forest engulf him. The tall trees loomed above him like threatening shadows, their bare branches stretching toward the sky like desperate hands. Every step he took on the frozen snow was accompanied by a harsh sound, like an echo that seemed to reverberate throughout the forest, breaking the oppressive silence that reigned in that place. The silence of the forest was not a comforting one, but rather a silence filled with an unseen tension, with an imminent danger lurking in every dark corner. As Kai ventured deeper into the forest, he began to feel the first signs of the magic that ruled it. This was not a friendly magic, but a deceptive one, making its presence felt through subtle traps and hidden threats. At first, Kai encountered spirits of winter, created from snowflakes and freezing winds. These spirits seemed to be made of the very essence of cold, dancing around him with graceful but dangerous movements. They moved in circles around him, trying to confuse his path and lure him into the depths of the forest where no one had ever returned. Kai felt tempted to follow them, but he remembered his mission and, with a heart full of determination, managed to keep his direction, ignoring their seductive whispers. Before long, the forest began to reveal another side. From the shadows of the trees emerged creatures born of darkness, strange and terrifying beings without precise form, who seemed to be the embodiment of his deepest fears. These creatures attacked without warning, but Kai, with his sword in hand and an unyielding heart, managed to face and defeat them. Every step forward was a test of will and courage, and the forest seemed alive, turning against him as if all of nature was conspiring to stop him. As the road became increasingly difficult, Kai felt his strength gradually leaving him. The forest seemed endless, and the obstacles he encountered at every step tested his physical and mental limits. The piercing cold, which did not relent for even a moment, numbed his hands and froze his breath. Each step became a struggle, and Kai felt the burden of the journey weighing heavier and heavier upon him. One night, exhausted and nearly defeated, Kai sat down at the base of an ancient tree. It was a dark night, with the moon barely managing to make its way through the heavy, leaden clouds. Kai felt overwhelmed by despair, wondering if he would ever reach his destination. Dark thoughts enveloped his mind, and the fatigue dragged him into a deep and oppressive sleep. Just when he felt that all was lost, a gentle light appeared out of nowhere, catching his attention. It was a warm, radiant light that seemed to dispel the darkness around him, like a guiding star in a night without end. From that light, a fairy with long, glowing hair materialized, radiating an inner peace and unimaginable beauty. The fairy approached Kai with light steps, and her presence had a soothing effect, banishing all the fears and pains that haunted him. The fairy introduced herself as Lumina, and her voice was so warm and sweet that each of her words seemed to be a balm for Kai's weary soul. She spoke to him gently, telling him that she had watched his journey and had been impressed by his courage and the purity of his heart. Lumina revealed that his path to the fairy's sanctuary was not without hope, but that before he could return the ring, he would have to face the greatest challenge yet. Lumina told him about the Forest King, an ancient creature born of nature's suffering and the fairy's fury. This being, who ruled over the forest with an iron hand, was the greatest threat Kai would face. The Forest King was not just a fearsome adversary, but also a symbol of the Earth's anger itself, of nature that had been wounded and now sought revenge. With his heart revitalized and encouraged by the fairy's presence, Kai stood up from the base of the tree. Lumina guided him through the forest's darkness, and so Kai's journey continued, his heart filled with hope and determination. Kai's long and perilous journey had finally brought him to the fairy's sanctuary, a place he had only heard of in whispered legends. The fairy's sanctuary was not visible like an ordinary building. Rather, it seemed like an extension of the forest itself, a place where nature and magic blended into perfect harmony. Though now, it was a harmony distorted by the curse that weighed on the kingdom. But just when he thought he had reached the end of his journey, a deafening roar echoed from the depths of the forest, a cry that seemed to come from the very core of the earth. The forest king, a colossus of ice and shadow, approached with heavy steps, filling the air with a threatening and overwhelming presence. Each step he took made the earth tremble, and the sky above seemed to darken even more under his weight. His eyes, glowing with boundless fury, fixed on the young prince with an intensity that would have crushed the soul of any other man. But Kai, though he felt a deep fear, did not back down. He knew that this creature was not just a physical adversary, but a symbol of nature's anger and the suffering his father's mistake had brought upon the kingdom. He drew his sword, ready for battle, but at the same time, aware that brute force would not be enough to defeat such an adversary. In that moment of tension, Kai realized there was another way, one that required not just courage, but also sacrifice. The battle that followed was not a typical one. The Forest King attacked with devastating power, but Kai did not retaliate. Instead, he focused on understanding the pain and fury that fueled this creature. Every blow he avoided brought him closer to a profound realization. The only way to tame this being was through sacrifice. With a heart full of resolve and an unexpected calm, Kai stopped moving and let his sword fall into the snow. At that moment, he looked into the Forest King's eyes and, without averting his gaze, knelt before him. He stretched out his arms, offering himself as payment for his father's mistake, acknowledging that only his sacrifice could bring peace. "I have not come to destroy you," Kai said with a firm but humble voice. "I have come to right my father's wrong. I am prepared to pay the price." The Forest King paused, stunned by the young prince's gesture. For a moment, the entire forest seemed to hold its breath, waiting for the verdict of this crucial moment. The colossus's eyes, which had been full of rage, gradually softened. He looked at Kai with a new understanding, realizing that this young man had not come to fight but to sacrifice himself for the good of his kingdom. Then, the fairy Lumina approached Kai. With tears in her eyes, she understood that his sacrifice was real and sincere. In a gesture of compassion and love, Lumina accepted the ring Kai offered with a heavy heart, but filled with hope. The moment the ring touched the fairy's delicate hands, a brilliant light spread from it, releasing the ring's magical power, and with it, breaking the curse that had weighed on the kingdom. The fairies, witnesses to this sacrifice, were deeply moved by Kai's courage and humility. They, who had once been full of anger, now felt immense compassion for this young man, who had been willing to give up his own life to correct a mistake from the past. In a gesture of forgiveness and gratitude, the fairies allowed Kai to live. Moreover, they decided to grant the kingdom of Almaris new life, one where spring would return and the earth would be reborn. The light released from the ring flooded the forest, melting the snows and freeing the earth from the grip of eternal winter. flowers began to bloom again, and the birds, which had been silent until then, resumed their songs, announcing the return of life. The frozen rivers thawed and began to flow freely, and the trees once again donned their green leaves. The entire kingdom felt this transformation as a long-awaited miracle. In his castle, King Ethan, weakened and on his deathbed, felt an immense weight lift from his heart. He understood now that his son had succeeded where he had failed, bringing not only peace to the kingdom, but also peace to his soul. Kai returned home as a hero, but not one glorified for feats of arms. Rather, he was celebrated for his sacrifice and wisdom. He was no longer just a prince, but a wise king who had learned a profound lesson. True power does not lie in magic or strength, but in the heart and in sacrifice. Under his rule, the kingdom was reborn, and his people prospered once again, learning to cherish nature and the balance it offers. The story of Kai and King Ethan became a legend, passed down from generation to generation, not just as a tale of adventure, but as a warning and a lesson about pride, error, and redemption. And so, dear listeners, we have reached the end of our adventure, the fairy ring and the curse from the past. So remember that within every dream lies a lesson of love and forgiveness, and in the heart of every sacrifice, a drop of hope awaits to be discovered. If you enjoyed this enchanting journey, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe, and press the notification bell so you never miss a new story full of magic. Until next time, may you have sweet dreams and magical adventures every night.